Welcome to St. Luke for Mass this weekend. A special welcome to anyone who may be joining us online for the first time. I invite you to pray and sing with each other as we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Easter.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
We praise you, we bless you.
Let us pray. Grant Almighty God that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relieve in remembrance, we may always hold to it in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people. And many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now, when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Beloved, Sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope. But do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned, those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. The word of the Lord.
Imagine our lives without traffic signs and regulations. Life on the road would become dangerous. cars would drive on either side, and at the intersections, there would be no traffic lights at all. No one would slow down or stop. There would be a chaos in traffic, and many people would lose their lives. And it's similar with all the laws of the world. Laws helps us to guide on our journey. They are a kind of dividing lines of our life. On one hand, they limit us, but at the same time, they protect us. Without laws, people would destroy each other, society, the church. The Easter season is coming to an end. And the Lord Jesus is preparing his own disciples on their departure. Jesus called simple people, leading them and teaching them. There will come a time he will have to say goodbye to them. The disciples will be sent out to the world without their master and will be afraid of their lives. Therefore, the Lord gives them commandments, guiding their activities. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. To love Christ is keeping commandments. And it's never been easy. When we look at the early church, Christ's disciples suffer a lot for his teaching and for love of him. Under their master, they didn't hesitate to suffer many persecutions and lay down their own lives. We must admit that it is not different today. No one is persecuted for Christ, and everyone can live in their own happiness. But today's times offer different problems and temptations to face. Christ's commandments are still relevant today and have something to tell us, to me, to you, to the 21st century. It is difficult to gratify the Lord today when the world offers us so many temptations, so many opportunities to sin. From each side, we encounter different resistance. And in today's language, my faith, your faith, our faith, it's not cool today. Man is often influenced by his surroundings. He or she is afraid to manifest the faith passed down from parents, grandparents. Helping neighbors, going to church, approaching the sacraments, it doesn't appeal today. Some look at the faith of others and ridicule us. I wish myself and you never to go astray from our path to Christ. Keep in mind that Jesus' commandments do not limit us. They are not here to punish us. They are given to help us in our daily lives, in our daily responsibilities. And if we did not have them, we would be in the dark and not know where to go. Before us, many disciples of Christ suffered, were persecuted, died. But eventually, they gain a crown of glory. Christ's crown of glory. So each one of us is called to live those commandments that Christ left for us. So each one of us can carry that crown of glory forever. Amen. And now, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Believing that the Spirit of the risen Jesus dwells within us, let us offer our prayers for the Church and our world.
For the Church and for fuller discipleship, following Jesus' command to love one another, may we live sacrificial lives focused on the needs of our families, on those suffering in our communities and the nation, recognizing that we are all sisters and brothers, and that Christ is one with all of us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders and for government and business leaders, that God will inspire them to develop policies to protect the health and well-being of the human family and promote the renewal of the economy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose lives have been upended by the coronavirus, for those who are suffering from serious illness, and for those whose life's work is to care for them, may they all be given the strength and grace to share in the mission of Jesus the healer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are struggling to feed themselves and their families, may the generosity of those who have what they need be shared a hundredfold to take care of their neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the many who have died, and for those who grieve for them. For Karen Hollebaugh, who died this week. In our liturgy today, we remember especially Dorothy Tama and Frank Whitman. May all be given the peace of the risen Jesus who is with us, and who has not left us orphans. Let us pray to the Lord. For the needs contained in our prayer box, on our prayer chain, for those contained in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Good and gracious God, graciously bestow us upon us your blessings, because you live and reign forever and ever. Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine of you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become the spiritual food. The humble spirit and contrite heart may be accepted by you all. And we are sacrificing your soul this day, the pleasing to you, Lord God. For my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all our holy church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant, Francis our Pope, and George our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit, and let us offer to one another a sign of the peace that we have in Christ.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be shut in the mouth, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of the saving food. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us go to spread the good news of the gospel.
Thanks be to God.